In today's video, we will discuss very important topic of English literature, that is contemporary English poetry. So in this contemporary English poetry, I will discuss the neo-romanticism, the apocalyptic movement, the movement poetry, and all these three movements poets: Elizabeth Jennings, Kingsley Amis, Thomas Gunn, Philip Larkin, Dylan Thomas, Ted Hooks. So these are very important poets of this contemporary poetry of English literature. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do now the subscribe and support, encourage, share this video, suggest for the improvement of this quality of the video. Now we'll discuss one by one these three movements and these all poets. See, contemporary poetry. In every question paper, there may be a question on contemporary English poetry. So this contemporary English poetry plays a vital role in English literature. So mostly Philip Larkin, Thomas Gunn, Dylan Thomas, Sylvia Plath, Elizabeth Jennings. So these poets play a very vital role in the contemporary English poetry of English literature. So these poets are the very dominating figures of that contemporary poetry, especially Philip Larkin and Ted Hooks, Dylan Thomas, Thomas Gunn. So these four are play a very vital role. They gave their own contribution to that English contemporary poetry. Now we have to look at what are the characteristics of this contemporary poetry. See, the characteristics of contemporary poetry. How this contemporary poetry is entirely different from that of the previous poetry, is the modern poetry and war poetry, Jajan poetry, and Oxford movement poetry, and that is romantic and also Victorian poetry. So what are the characteristics? There may be a question on this characteristics of the contemporary poetry also in the question paper. So that's why I discuss the characteristics of contemporary poetry also. See, the first characteristics is that the poetry reflected post-war disillusionment, the impact of science and industrial society, and an light cosmopolitanism. The traditional verse forms and the paraphrases content of poetry were rejected. See, in the modern or in the contemporary poetry, the theme, the traditional verse forms and the paraphrases content of poetry is quietly rejected. New poetry characterized by free verse, missing syntactic link, and recondite allusions became obscure and difficult for the common reader. The contemporary poetry is the poetry of revolt. Revolt. Poetic vocabulary had been drained to its lees. The poetry has a deeper sense of the tragedy of everyday life. See, the modern poetry's the most important characteristics is the modern poetry has a deeper sense of the tragedy of everyday life of the people. See, the contemporary poetry is not a philosophy of despair. The poet does not in all moods sing the psalm of death. He sees all life as a square and sees it whole. But with the advance of science and industry, poetry does not necessarily decline. Concept of nature, love for animals, religious dogma, and humorous are incorporated in the contemporary poetry's theme. See, first you have to see the neo-romanticism, the neo-romantic movement. So in this neo-romanticism, see, Dylan Thomas and George Barker weaned away the poetry from the political content which characterized the poetry of Oxford poets? So these two, Dylan Thomas and Jas Barker, these are very important figures of this neo-romanticism movement. See, they gave prominence to religious and romanticism. Dylan Thomas and Barker were the pioneers of neo-romanticism poetry. Remember these two names of the poets. And the enemy of intellectual in verse. See, now the next contemporary moment, that is apocalyptic moment, it took place in the contemporary English poetry. So look at how it took place. See, it was a short-lived poetic moment of the 40s of the 20th century. It was influenced by the Book of Revelation, Shakespeare, Blake, Kafka from French, Sidon, Hopkins and Dylan Thomas. It was a natural development from the surrealism of the 40s and the mood of violence that began to creep into the fabric of poetry. It was opposed to left-wing hedonism and the machine age. It proclaimed its faith in the individual and not on community. The poets of the moment are, who are the apocalyptic moment poets? See, J.F. Henry and Henry Treece, who edited The New Apocalypse in 1940 and The White Horseman 1941, were the pioneers. Other poets are Nicholas Moray, G.S. Fraser, Tom Scott and Vernon Watkins. So these are the important poets of this apocalyptic moment of the contemporary English poetry. Now we have to look at the main important moment of modern English poetry, and that is contemporary English poetry, that is moment poetry. See, this Daisy Enright's anthology, Poets of the 50s, 1956, and Robert Conquest anthology brought 9 poets to notice. They were John Wayne, Kingsley Amis, John Holloway, Donald Davis, D.J. Enright, Philip Larkin, Thomas Gunn, Robert Conquest and Elizabeth Jennings. So these are the main important poets of this moment poetry of the contemporary English poetry. So among these, see, Philip Larkin, Thomas Gunn are very, very important poets. See, the majority of these poets belong to the working class or lower middle class, and all of them were educated at Oxford or Cambridge. Critics called these new poets as belong to moment. They were also known as university wits or new Empsonians. So now we look at first Elizabeth Jennings. She was born in 1926 in Boston, Lincolnshire. She attended the St. Anne's College. She is regarded as traditional rather than an innovator. She is known for her lyric poetry and mastery of forms. She deeply held Roman Catholicism, colored much of her work. She is called as a bag lady of sonnets. She wrote many sonnets. See her works, A Way of Looking, A Sense of the World, Song for a Birth or a Death, The Sonnets of Michelangelo, The Mind Has Mountains, The Secret Brother and other poems for children. See, next poet of this moment poetry is that is Kingsley Amis. He was born in 1922 in Clapham, London, England. He was an English novelist, critic, poet, and a teacher. He wrote more than 20 novels, 6 volumes of poetry, a memoir, and short stories. He also wrote social and literary criticism. He was also one of the important movement poets. Amis became one of the writers of the Angry Young Man movement, and this Kingsley Amis is also regarded as one of the most important modern tradition of novel, that is campus novels. See, works of Kingsley Amis: Bright November, A Frame of Mind, Poems, Fantasy Portraits, A Case of Samples, Poems 1946-56, The Evans County, A Look Round the Estate, are important works of Kingsley Amis. Now we have to look at the most important poet of the modern poetry. So that is Thomas Gunn. He was born in 1929 in Gravesend, Kent, England, the son of Bert Gunn. He attended the University College School in Hampstead, London, and Trinity College, Cambridge. He was an English poet who was praised for his early verse in England. As a young man, he wrote poetry associated with the moment. His poetry is about gay related topics and drug use, sex, and his bohemian lifestyle. He won major literary awards, and his best poems have a compact philosophy elegance. See, the works of Thomas Gunn are The Man with Night Sweats, Fighting Terms, The Sense of the Moment, My Sad Captain and Other Poems, To the Air, Jockstraw Castle, Touch, Molly, The Occasion of Poetry, An Essay, The Hurtle Trees. So now we have to look at the main important and dominating figure of that moment poetry of the modern English poetry, that is Philip Larkin. He was the head of the moment poetry. He was born in 9th August 1922, Radford, Coventry, United Kingdom. Brunette Kalemun was a pseudonym used by the poet and writer Philip Larkin. So you have to remember Brunette Kalemun. This is the pseudonym of Philip Larkin. This question may ask in the question paper, which is the pseudonym of Philip Larkin. He was educated at St. John's College, Oxford. He was the dominating figure of the moment poetry. He was an English poet, novelist, and librarian. He contributed to the Daily Telegraph magazine or literary magazine. Now to look at the works of Philip Larkin. So, The North Sea, The Less Deceived, The Whitsun Wedding, very important poem of Philip Larkin, The High Windows, and also the Philip Larkin edited the Oxford Book of 20th Century English Verse, which was published in 1973. See, his famous poems are, see, The Toads, Toads Revisited, Mr. Blaney, Church Going at Gross. See, Church Going is very, very important and famous poem of Philip Larkin, and this Whitsun Wedding. These are very important. You have to keep at least these two poems of Philip Larkin in your mind for the exam point of view. Another one important figure of that moment poetry is Dylan Thomas. See, he was a Welsh poet and writer. He was born in 1914 in Swansea, Wales, United Kingdom. He was a forerunner of angry young man of 50s. Thomas Gunnars was also angry young man. His romantic revolt unleashed a coarseness and richness of language, reveling in comedy and bawdry and affirmation of holy myths rather than a sniveling at God and an orgy of the irrational. He wrote poetry for the love of man and in praise of God. Works of Dylan Thomas. The first work is The Force That Through the Green Fuse Drives the Flower, published in 1933. And Death Shall Have No Dominion, very important poem of Dylan Thomas. Poems in October, The October Wind, 24 Years Remind the Tears of My Eyes, poem on his birthday. So very important. And another one important poem is Fern Hill. So you have to remember Fern Hill and Death Shall Have No Dominance. So these are very important poem for the exam point of Fern Hill and Death Shall Have No Dominion. Remember these poems for the exam point of view in your mind. See, a refusal to mourn the death of a child in London. So next important poet of this contemporary is Ted Hughes. See, he was born in 1930 in Mittelmroyd, United Kingdom. He was an English poet, translator, and children's writer. He was appointed as the Poet Laureate in 1984 and held the office until his death. Hughes married to American poet Sylvia Plath from 1956 until her death, suicide in 1963 at the age of 30. You know, Ted Hughes married the famous American poet, that is Sylvia Plath. Sylvia Plath is famous for her confessional poetry, including with others or with other poets. This Sylvia Plath created a new kind of poetry in English literature, that is confessional poetry. We'll discuss in the next video about that confessional poetry and Sylvia Plath. See, works. The Hawk in the Rain, Lupercal, Waldo. See, Crow from the Life and the Songs of the Crow, Cowbirds, Audit, Remains of Elmet, Moortown, Flowers and Insects, Wolf Watching, Rain Charm for the Duchy. So these are important works of Ted Hughes. So another one, Rock Hosting, is also a very famous poem of Ted Hughes. So you have to remember these poets, especially that Philip Larkin, Dylan Thomas, Ted Hughes, and also Thomas Gunn. These four poets of this contemporary English literature are very, very important for the exam point of view. So in every year question paper, there is a question on these tradition or this contemporary poetry. So I think you have to read and also watch this video. You will make use of this video's information. So and also, if you haven't subscribe and share. You have to like. Nobody, you are watching my videos and not liking my videos. What will cost to you? You have to watch. And also, I'm giving you free service. Nobody is giving free service now. So you have to watch and share and also like my videos. That's also helps to me. It's an inspire. Your liking and your sharing is an inspiration to me to make the other next videos. I think and I hope you will do that. Now I'm ending this video. Thank you for watching this video. Keep watching.